2023. Welcome back to your Tuesday morning. Lesley Anne Scorgie joining us once again. Happy 2018 to you.
Yes, happy new year.
Yeah, we haven't seen you in a while, but you're here and Vancouver going green, speaking your language, but how going green can help improve your financial life. Some basic ideas, and you're starting with ideas inside the home.
That's right. So some of the bigger investments are replacing your doors and windows and furnaces. That can add up to many tens of thousands of dollars and can take up to 10 years to pay off. But longer term, it's worth it because you'll see the value come back when you eventually sell your house. You can also upgrade something like a thermostat for much less.
That is an interesting point because sometimes it's overwhelming with the investment involved, but when you're looking at the long game and saying, hey, this is what you're going to save 5-10 years down the line, you're going to win.
It's an expectation of buyers now.
Okay, so that's tip number one. Food waste. This is always a challenge. We talked about plastic waste on the show in the last week. What do you find with food waste and how we can improve things?
So, for an average family here in British Columbia, it can be up to $1,000 a year of money literally going out the door and into the garbage. We recommend meal planning with just about everybody we talk to on this subject. It allows you to stay fit, healthy, but also control costs. Second thing you can do is you can look at not buying any bottled beverages from now on. Get one of those, you know, trusty old canteens from your garage, clean it up, and carry your own water. It'll be great for your waistline and your wallet.
Yeah, that is great here with the bottled water too when we look at our carbon footprint and how things add up. Okay, what about the idea of transportation? Zero emission vehicles, these are big investments in their own right.
It's, as a financial consultant, this area is fascinating to me because it's actually influencing our investment markets right now. We have new exchange traded funds like cars coming out. And what I think is fascinating is that you don't necessarily need to invest in a brand new Tesla. There are over a dozen other brands of clean, safe cars. And a website that I absolutely love to reference is Plug and Drive. It compiles all of the grants and the car technologies that are available to you that are clean, safe, and automated so that you don't have to fork out tens of thousands of dollars above your budget. Remember, those grants are up to you to discover where they're located, how to apply for them, and reference the provincial government website. That's probably your best bet. But really, what you want to do first and foremost is figure out what your budget is, stay within it. Again, I think this is an area we're going to see a lot of progress being made all across the board, technology all the way to where we're investing our money. Fascinating, right?
Well, the environmental footprint is something that's at the top of everybody's mind, but I even think about the idea of eating healthy. There's a big cost involved with trying to pull that off. So simple hacks, any other hacks that stand out to you of how you can help clean up your lifestyle?
So absolutely. I am a big fan of minimalism. And if you can go through your house right now and ask the question, do I love this or do I need to move it on to a new home, what you can end up doing is reducing what you need in the home and just focusing your dollars on better quality so that you're throwing out less in the long run. One of my favorite documentaries right now on Netflix is Minimalism, and I believe it's actually called The Minimalist. And it's fascinating because it shows you how minimalism actually can impact your bank account but reduce your environmental footprint at the same time.
Got to check out this doc, and that is a great jump start on spring cleaning with these ideas too. Mevest.ca, that's the website for more resources on going green, saving money, because that's what we all want to do. Yeah. Lesley Anne Scorgie is her name. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Riaz.
Always great to have you on.
Thank you.
We'll take a break.